Assalamualaikum. Today we are discussing on the topic of April to a febrile patient. Lies an elevated core body temperature of more than 38 degrees Celsius in response to cytokines and acute phase proteins and occurs in infection and non-infectious conditions. There is general variation in of fever in normal adult. Normal temperature in adult is 36.8 plus minus 0.4 degrees Celsius. Lowest at 6 a.m. is 37.2 degrees Celsius. Highest at 4 p.m. that is 37.7 degrees Celsius. Hyperpyrexia, defined as increase in temperature more than 41 degrees Celsius. Hyperthermia, characterized by a normothermic setting of thermoregulatory center in conjunction with uncontrolled rise in body temperature that exceeds the body's ability to lose heat. Feverishness, when a patient feels fever but the temperature is below 100 degree Fahrenheit. Types of fever, there are three types of fever. Continuous, when fever does not fluctuate more than about 1 degree Celsius during 24 hours and never touches baseline, as for example, enteric fever, miliary tuberculosis, lobar pneumonia. Intermittent fever, when daily fluctuations exceed 2 degree Celsius, as for example, amoebic liver abscess, lung abscess. Remittent fever, when the fever is present only for several hours during the day. There are three types of remittent fever. Quotidian, occurs daily, as for example, kalajar. Tertian fever, occurs on alternate days, as for example, Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale malady. Quartan fever, 2 days intervene between two consecutive attacks, that is, Plasmodium malady infection. There are some fever patterns of different types of fever. Mechanism of fever. Introduction of exogenous pyrogen causes tissue damage, causes monocyte activity. Increased production of endogenous pyrogen, that is interleukin 1, interleukin 6, tumor necrosis factor, and interferon, causes the stimulation of production of prostaglandin E2 and causes hypothalamus reset and thus causes fever. Approach to a febrile patient. Now, history taking. Presenting complaints. How was the fever documented? What is the severity and time course? Have there been any rigors and sweating? Duration of the fever. Is there any diurnal variation of the fever? Has there been any rash or skin changes? If yes, ask about its timing in relation to fever. The distribution and direction of any progression and associated symptoms, that is, pruritus, local lymphadenopathy. Systematically ask about localizing symptoms, for example, cough, pruritic chest pain, purulent sputum, vomiting, abdominal pain, jaundice, diarrhea, dysuria, urinary frequency, headache, neck stiffness, altered consciousness, joint pain, muscle aches, throat or ear discomfort, and nasal distress. Are there any constitutional symptoms including easy fatigability, anorexia, weight loss, falls, change in daily activities or behavior? Such symptoms may indicate infection in the elderly or immunocompromised. Past medical history. Have there been previous similar incident? Has there been previous or recurrent infections, illness, surgical operations or dental treatment? Has there been contact or residence in a healthcare facility? Ask about the history of immunocompromisation, as for example, diabetes mellitus, chemotherapy, steroid therapy, transplantation, HIV infection. Ask about indwelling catheters, such as urethras, IV or implant, such as pacemakers, joint replacement in the past. Now, drug history. Find out about all prescribed and non-prescribed medications, as for example, herbal remedies taken, and ask specifically about immunosuppressant, antibiotics and antipyretics. Have any recreational drugs been taken? If so, have they ever been injected? Note any history of adverse reactions, allergies, or hypersensitivity to any drugs, particularly antibiotics. Family and social history. Has the patient had contact with anyone with a similar illness? Find out about exposure to animals, birds, or pets, and if so, is the animal unwell? Note the patient's occupation and hobbies. Are there clusters of similar symptoms or infections among family, friends, or workmates? Traveling history. As so, take a detailed travel history, including travel destinations, environmental abroad, lifestyle, medical history. If he travels to any developing country, we can search for malaria, dengue, typhoid, tuberculosis, dysentery, amoebiasis, schistosomiasis, hepatitis A, tick typhus. If anywhere in the country, then we can search for influenza, pneumonia, upper respiratory tract infection, urinary tract infection, traveler's diarrhea. Now, general physical examination. We have to look for temperature, appearance, body build, anemia, may be present in case of malignancy, jaundice, may be present in case of hepatitis, clubbing, bony tenderness, may be present in case of leukemia, dehydration may be present in case of diarrhea, pulse, there is proportional increase of pulse for each degree rise of temperature, blood pressure, oxygen saturation, lymphadenopathy, neck stiffness, skin for rashes or drug use, IV cannula site for an infection, intruding catheter for any infection. A systemic examination. Central nervous system examination. We have to look for necrosity, carnic sign. Head and neck examination. Tympanic membrane for middle ear infection. Frontal and maxillary sinuses for sinusitis. Examination of the nose for constriction and discharge. Inspection of the mouth for inflammation or oral candidiasis. Examination of the sclera for conjunctivitis. Lymph node for lymphadenopathy. Respiratory system. Percussion and auscultation of lungs for any Krebs, effusion or sign of consolidation. Cardiovascular system. Auscultation of the heart for murmurs may be present in case of endocarditis. Abdomen examination. Palpation of the abdomen for any organomegaly or tenderness. Look for renal angle tenderness may be present due to pyelonephritis. Pelvic examination. For any tenderness. Genital examination. For any tenderness or enlargement. Rectal examination for any tenderness or swelling. Major joint examination for any swelling or tenderness. May indicate rheumatoid arthritis or any infection. Red flag features of fever. Altered mental state. Headache, neck stiffness, skin rash, bleeding manifestation. Features of shock, that is hypertension. Systolic blood pressure less than 90 mm mercury, tachycardia, heart rate more than 90, tachypnea, respiratory rate more than 20 per minute, hyperpyrexia more than 100 degree Fahrenheit, body ache, sore throat, jaundice, rigors, recent travel to or travel from endemic area of Kalajar, tuberculosis, malaria or COVID-19. Now we are going through the COVID-19 pandemic. By taking history properly, we can initially differentiate it from common cold and flu. Fever, common in COVID-19, rare in common cold, common in flu. Cough, common in COVID-19, common in cold, common in flu. Sore throat, occasional in COVID-19, common in common cold, occasional in flu. Shortness of breath, occasional in COVID-19, rare in cold, rare in flu. Fatigue, occasional in COVID-19, occasional in cold, common in flu. Aches and pain, occasional in COVID-19, rare in cold, common in flu. Headaches, occasional in COVID-19, common in cold, common in flu. Runny nose, occasional in COVID-19, common in cold, occasional in flu. Diarrhea, common in COVID-19, rare in cold, occasional in case of children in flu. Anosmia, occasional in COVID-19, occasional in cold, common in flu. Pyrexia of unknown origin. Urination, temperature above 38 degrees Celsius on multiple occasions for more than 3 weeks without diagnosis despite initial investigations in hospital for 1 week. Causes of pyrexia of unknown origin. Infection, constitute of 30%. Tuberculosis, respiratory infection, urinary tract infection, dengue, typhoid, malaria, bone and joint infection, viral infection, fungal infection, infective endocarditis. Non-infectious, constitute of malignancy 20%, connectivity disorder 15%, miscellaneous 20%, and there are idiopathic causes constitute of 15% of cause. Investigations. First-line investigation, complete blood count with ESR. There are different findings that may indicate different type of causes. Neutrophilia, mostly due to bacterial fever. Neutropenia, mostly due to viral and typhoid fever. Lymphocytosis, mostly due to viral. Lymphopenia, mostly due to HIV infection. Thrombocytopenia, mostly due to malarial fever. CT X-ray, peer view. Urine routine microscopic examination, urine culture and sensitivity. C-reactive protein usually elevated in infection. Second line investigations are according to the fever pattern or according to the history. Blood culture, throat swab for culture, liver function test, renal function test, serum ferritin D-dimer, real-time PCR, NSN antigen, sputum culture, Montauk test, GeneXpert, CSF culture, CT scan of brain, autoantibody test, PPF for parasite, echocardiogram. Reasons to treat fever. Every increase in 1 degree Celsius over 37 degree Celsius causes in 13% increase in oxygen consumption. Fever can aggravate pre-existing cardiac, cerebrovascular or pulmonary insufficiency. Fever increase metabolic demand. Fever increase protein breakdown. Reasons not to treat. Moderate elevations of body temperature may increase chemotaxis, decrease microbial replication, improve lymphocyte function. Fever directly inhibits growth of certain bacteria and viruses. Management. Non-pharmacological management. Keep it sponging to cool down the skin. Replacement of salt and water in patients with drenching sweats. Pharmacological management, antipyretics, treatment of underlying diseases. Conclusions. Fever is a symptom, not a disease. Careful history and physical examination will reveal source of most fever. Recognize life threats early. Make decisions about benefits of treating fever before doing so. Thank you.